Hey, I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, and I've got a cool Excel tip for you today.
Hey, this is Mike Girvin at Excel is Fun on YouTube, and I have a different way to do that.
All right, welcome back to another Dueling Excel podcast. Great question today that's going to generate a lot of different answers, I think. It's sent in from YouTube, from Faizee. We have some items here, and it says, if cell C7 contains either the word paper or sticker, then the category becomes paper slash stick. Otherwise, the category becomes card. All right, so as I start to attack this, I think about the find command. I want to find the word paper within that cell, and find is going to give me a number, and I really don't care about the number, or it's going to give me an error. So I'm interested in wrapping that whole function in the isError function. Copy that down, and that's going to basically tell me if paper is not found. If I get a false, the paper's there. If I get a true, paper is not there, so it's saying that there's an error. Now, as I start to think about this one, this is a tricky problem because we have to check for paper, we have to check for card, and so I like to go back to my electrical engineering days and build something called a Karnaugh map. Now, with a Karnaugh map, you take a look at all the possible conditions. So I check to see if paper's not there, and I can get either a true or a false, and if sticker's not there, I get either a true or a false, and build a little table here of what the answer should be. And usually when you see this table visually, you'll understand the one condition that you're checking for, or the few conditions that you're checking for. And in this case, I'm looking for where both of the isError find formula fragments are generating trues, where both of those are trues. That's the place where I want to write to put the word card. So that leads me to this formula here. Rather long formula, I'll admit. I check to see if the isError of find of paper and the isError of find of sticker. I put both of those together into an and condition. If both of those are true, then my Karnaugh map tells me I'm supposed to put card, otherwise paper stick. So I enter that and copy it down, and sure enough, it works. If the word paper is there or if the word sticker is there, we get paper slash stick. Otherwise, we get card. Now, I thought about this, and I said, well, I wonder if we can shorten that formula at all, maybe using a CSE formula, a CTRL+SHIFT+ENTER formula. And I said, wouldn't it be cool if the find function could handle an array of values? So what's happening here is I'm asking the find function to look for both paper and stick within C7, take the isError of that, and then take the and of that whole big long thing. If both of those are true, if both of those items are returning a 1 or a true, then we put the word card, otherwise paper stick. Now, to make this work, Control Shift Enter. It's because we have an array in there, and copy it down, a little bit of special copying, and it works with an array formula. This certainly would be the way to go if you had 3, 4, 5, 6 different categories to check, because you could just put them right here inside the curly brackets and could check them all. If all of them were true, then you have a certain value. Otherwise, you have another value. All right, well, that's my take on it. Let's send this over to Mike and see what Mike has to do.
Thanks, Mr. Excel. Hey, now that was a great formula. Funny thing is, I came up with my formula and it's like exactly the opposite, except for it's still almost the same. Now watch this. He started off with if, which is what I did, and then he had an and, I had an or, and then he had an is error, I had an is number, and then he used find. Find was the key for finding whether paper or card or sticker was in the cell. Find is case sensitive. I decided to use search, which is exactly the same as find except for it's not case sensitive. And the find text, we're going to use that array syntax, so curly bracket, and then in quotes, paper, and double quote. Now, a comma means a column. I'm going to use a semicolon, which means row. That is how in array syntax you can make a full table using array syntax. And then the same thing, sticker, and double quote, and end curly bracket. Now, comma and the within text, same thing. Close parentheses, close parentheses, close parentheses. Now, we're back to this whole thing right here is the logical test. Then we have to say what the value if true and value if false. Now let's just look at this. The search and the find, if there's no difference in case, then they'll return the same thing. So Mr. Excel's formula and mine will return the same thing. But watch this. Is number. Now, paper and sticker, we're looking for that. When I ask for is number, let's just take a look here. If I highlight this and hit the F9 key to evaluate it, notice it says 5 and value. Now, I'm asking is number so I can find either one of these, which is why I use the OR. As soon as it sees one, it knows that it's either paper or sticker. That's why is number works here. It says is or one of these a number. This will be true, this will be false, and the OR will see that one of them are true. The way Mr. Excel did it is both of these had to come out to be value errors, which means search didn't find it. That's why he used is error, so when they're both errors, then the and, which means both have to be true, evaluates to true. Now I'm going to Control-Z. What that all means is that I've determined to find paper or sticker, so the value if true, because of the way I set up the OR, is number, and search, that comes as the value of true, whereas Mr. Excel's formula, card, came as the value of true. So then my value of false is simply card. And then end double quote, close parentheses. Now, also another interesting aspect, when you use this array syntax in some formulas, you actually don't have to use Control-Shift-Enter. So I'm just going to hit Enter and then copy it down. To show you another example of sometimes not of having this array syntax and not requiring Control-Shift-Enter, how about summing the largest two, right? So I said large and give me the first largest and second largest. That's another example of when you have this array syntax and you don't use Control-Shift-Enter, it just knows to work. Now, a couple other possibilities here. If I look over here, instead of all of that, we could do if, or, and replace. This replace right here, this is a little construct that looks at everything up to the space and replaces it with a blank. So then that replace will find the paper, paper, card, card, sticker. So that right there checks to see against paper and sticker. So again, either one of these come out to be true, the OR will say true, and then it dumps paper and sticker or card if false. The another possibility is VLOOKUP. That same replace right here is just going to pull out the paper, card, sticker, and then VLOOKUP looks it up in the first column and dumps this in to the cell. So those are options also. All right, we'll see you next trick.
Yeah, Mike, that was completely the same as mine while being completely different and actually a lot better. So, point to Mike. Hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another dueling podcast from Mr. Excel and Excel is Fun.